Guys, welcome to Mom's Church Home. We are going to show you today how to freeze cookie dough. We have made a huge batch of the Nestle Toll House chocolate chip cookies. And what we're going to do is I made two different kinds. I made one with the triple chip and then the regular Nestle Toll House cookie. And I've got a lot in the oven, but since there's just a small family here, it's two people, we are actually going to take part of the dough, which is probably about half, approximately half of the dough, and is the full recipe that uses the two sticks of butter, the cup of butter. So it's a full recipe. And what we're gonna do is we are going to freeze the rest of our dough. Then when we have a hankering for some chocolate chip cookies homemade, we can just pull them out, cut them like they sell in the store, only these are homemade. So they're much better. There's none of that garbage in there, at least. We know what goes in the batch. And so because we're a small family, we don't, without the grandkids being here or other kids being here, we don't have the need to make this whole batch of cookies. So we are gonna freeze it. And I've got about a 10 by 10 piece of parchment paper out on this bowl right now. And I'll show you how we're gonna do this.
Okay, guys, right? The first thing you wanna do is all that leftover dough, you're gonna scrape it out of the bowl.
You know, it's pretty sticky. You're gonna just put it on the parchment paper. And you know, we wanna get all that out of there. Get it out. Get all that yummy dough out of the bowl. Give me a second. My hands are clean. I think everybody's hands are super clean right about now. We've been washing our hands incessantly. Just one second. Grab the spatula, and then we're just gonna make sure we get all that dough out of there. See, look at that, that's a lot. Use everything. Now set that bowl aside. And then, as I mentioned, my hands are clean. I think everybody in the world has super clean hands right about now. We're just gonna make this, you know, the dough is super sticky. So we're just gonna take our hands and make like a log. We're gonna make sure that's all mixed together though really well, because I see a couple places where chips aren't incorporated. We're just gonna make like a log. You know, the kind you buy in the store. Oops, my log's coming apart. This is what happens when the dough is, it's getting warm and it's been sitting out. So now we just have kind of a, just gonna have to mess with it a little bit. Now, you know, my hands are getting really messy. I do have walnuts in here. You have to make sure that this is frozen, especially with the walnuts in it. And I think we have a pretty good size log. Maybe make it just a little bit, pull it out just a little bit more. And I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna wash my hands. Okay, got my hands washed, and the reason I did that is I don't want to get sticky on the back side of the parchment paper. We are going to rewrap this in foil and put it in a Ziploc baggie. And so we're just going to take it and wrap it up in the parchment. And the nice thing about this is you can manipulate it just a little bit more. So I'm going to just pull it out just a little bit more so that we have a nice log. And this is going to be really, really nice once we have a hankering for cookies and we want homemade cookies. It's gonna be really, really nice to pull out of the freezer and have homemade cookies. Hey guys, we are gonna wrap this in foil. We've got it wrapped in parchment paper already. And wrap, you know, you're double wrapping it so no air gets in there. You don't get any freezer frost or freezer burn, whatever they call that. You want it to be nice and fresh when you do pull it out of the freezer. And this can last anywhere from 6 months to maybe a year, but you really probably won't let it sit in the freezer that long, trust me. But the homemade dough is so much nicer. You're gonna peel back those ends, and the foil works really good with that. Now, there you go, you got your roll of cookies. And we're gonna actually put it in a Ziploc bag to just make sure it stays fresh. Oh, it was closed. And then
We're going to write on the bag what it is. Oh, it barely fits. We're going to just squish that end. And there you go. You're going to want to pull all the air out of that, zip it up, label it, chocolate chip cookies, and you're ready to go. Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this video, give us a big thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.